Tell me when you're ready, guys. I can wait if we need to wait. Y'all, everybody good? We waiting on anybody?
Yeah, we're good.
We're tickled to death to be playing in the conference championship game. That's been our team's goal since day one. They got us here, and I'm real proud of our guys. We're playing a Tulane team, and I've said this before. I think they're one of the better teams in college football. We get to go on the road. They're placed for the second time, which is a tough feat. We had a really good game last time we played them. It went down to the end. We're going to play really good to win the game this time with that. You look at them, I mean, since we played them, they've played two really good football games. Went to Cincinnati. Cincinnati had lost them forever, and they went there and beat them. That was a really, really impressive win for them to do that, to get them the championship game. So they look pretty healthy. They look like they're playing really good football, so it'll be a good challenge. But that's what championship games are about, and so we'll see what happens. Questions?
I know today's your off day, but what can you tell us that you know of John Rice's status for Saturday? And given how he performed the last time against Tulane, how important is it that he plays?
Yeah, he actually feels better. The thing about it, he's dealt with this hamstring for a few weeks now, so it's not like something new, and he's managed it and been able to recover and come back. So, I mean, his mindset's to play, and so we'll see how he does each day. But it's not the first time, so I think that's probably a positive.
What kind of game like that against USF, where it's down to the wire, drama filled, some amazing catches at the end? What can the game like that do for your team heading into a conference championship?
Yeah, I think close games, it's about believing and finding a way and getting it done. I mean, there's nothing like feeling what it feels like with that pressure when the whole season is on the line and you've got to respond. And defensively, we didn't play our best, but when we needed to make the stop, they stopped, they punted, got the ball back, and the offense went down and scored. So, I think that says a lot about our leadership, the character of our team. We got a lot of winners. That's hard to do, especially when you're up 31-7 against your rival. You lose the lead, the place is going nuts. In those challenging times, that's when you truly find out about your football team. So to answer your question, I think if it's a close game, we know how to win at the end, and I think that's really important.
Coach, two quick ones here. First of all, the catch has been dubbed the Holy Hauler in some fields. Do you think that play was worthy of that name?
I think that play was worthy of whatever name you want to call it. I knew it was a pretty good catch on the sideline when it happened. I was just worried about him being in, and then I saw it on my phone after the game. Wow, that was crazy. That was a crazy play right there. So, and then when you put the fact of everything at the moment against your rival and how important it was, because, I mean, Boomer, I'd have felt good about him, but I didn't want to put a true freshman in that moment. And that was a wild catch.
And to kind of follow up with that, that's the last regular season game for UCF in the American. You've been coaching for a long time, wrote him a book. What's something you would amend to the book or add to the book in question, or just what have you learned from coaching in the American?
Well, I knew there was good teams before I got here, but there's nothing like when you go through it. And it's a real conference. There is more parity in college football now than ever before, and this conference has a lot to do with that. So for us to get the championship game in this conference, it's a really big deal. And, for both teams, are definitely, worthy.
After talking about the difficulty of trying to beat a team twice in the same season?
Yeah, there's no doubt, especially when you have to go to their place twice, when you play against each other, I mean, there's also adjustments that go with that from a coach's standpoint. And, what adjustments they're going to make, what adjustments we're going to make. Our players, they know, what it feels like. They understand the speed. They know the personnel. And so, I've had this a few times in my career. And so we'll know quite a bit about each other.
After wins and losses, you've talked about leaving points out on the field, be it turnovers or other mistakes. How important is that then this week with the caliber of opponent that you have, being on the road? You can't leave opportunities.
That's exactly right. I mean, championship games, I mean, there's a fine line, and you got to play your best games, and you got to be disciplined and not beat yourself, and you have the opportunities to present it. And my experience in championship games, I mean, you know, teams that win, they play their best game, and their best players have their best games, and that's what winning championships about.
What can you say about Mikey? He had to come in against Cincinnati, led you guys to a win, had to come in last week, executed that final drive, and that was his fourth game. And we asked him after the game that, you know, we know what the rules are with the red shirt.
Yeah.
For some reason, John Rice can't go. Are you willing to burn your red shirt? And he said, let's go win a championship. So what can you say about Mikey and what he's been able to do for you?
Yeah,
this year?
Yeah. I mean, I think anytime you're on the verge of a championship, I mean, it's all hands on deck, you know, ready to go, whatever you have to do to win. And we're so blessed to have team guys and like Mikey and others. And, you know, I'm real blessed to be coaching this bunch.
What do you make of the situation with Willie Fritz and the reports about Georgia Tech job? I mean, how is that something you guys talk about, that their head coach might not be coaching on Saturday? And does that change anything for you guys?
No, I mean, hey, he's one of the better coaches, you know, one of the hotter coaches in the country. That's part of the job description now. I mean, he just got to deal with it. It's not ideal, but, you know, we're expecting him to coach the team. He's got a championship-type team, and, you know, we'll see what happens after that. But it doesn't surprise me because he's really good.
Coach, heading into Tulane once again, obviously on the road again, a pure rematch in every shape, form, and fashion. But something else that you have in common with round one is there's kind of a shroud over the quarterback situation. We're not sure who's going to start, all that sort of stuff. Is that an extended advantage over all the disadvantages you face?
You know, I don't know. I don't think that plays too much into a championship-type game. I mean, if John Rice is healthy, he'll be our quarterback, you know, and if he's not, Mikey's ready, Thomas is ready. I mean, we're going to do whatever we got to do to give our guys the best chance of winning.
Following the game, you expressed disappointment about the tackling or lack thereof. What was most frustrating about seeing that throughout the game?
Yeah, I think we got a little worn down or whatever in the second half. You know, we're better on defense than we showed in that second half, and so, you know, we've got to respond, and, you know, I really feel like we will.
I mean, I'm sure, obviously, you'd rather be hosting the game on Saturday, but the fact you went there recently, you know the surroundings, you remember what the atmosphere was like. I don't know what it'll be this Saturday, but is that kind of reassuring that you kind of know what you're walking into to a degree?
Yeah, I think you're right about that, being familiar, because a lot of times when you go to a place you hadn't been there, you know, you're trying to, but we've been there. We got to know the locker room. We know the sideline. I mean, like, so I think that'll at least be better. Obviously, you wouldn't be playing at home, but the fact that you're familiar, I think that helps.
You ran for over 300 yards the last time you played Tulane, and John Rice was obviously a huge part of that success. So how do the tactics change if he's able to start but maybe not give you the same effectiveness with a hamstring injury like that?
Well, I mean, if he plays, he's gonna play like he does. And like I said, the good thing is he's managed that thing the last few weeks anyway, you know, and so he wasn't 100% either one of those deals last couple games. So, but if he plays, he's going to be ready to run.
How long has he been dealing with injuries? You said after the game at USF that he's had
yeah.
a healthy problem.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably a month. Yeah. I mean, you got it. I mean, he plays a, you know, he kind of plays a Cam Newton style game at quarterback. And, you know, those hits, you know, they kind of add up as the season goes on. So, you know, that had something to do with it too, probably.
Their star running back, Spears, I think he looked like he was a little bit limited when you guys played him, and he's really gone off the past couple of weeks. Just talk more about him and what a talent he is to try to contain.
Yeah, he's a real talent. He's real impressive to do what he's done the last 2 weeks, and they've been committed to getting it to him. I mean, you know, he carried a whole bunch of times last week. He'll carry a whole bunch of times against us, we feel like, and we're going to have to do a good job of fitting, you know, gang tackling better than we did, you know, last week.
Alec Haller had the game-winning catch last week against USF. Can you talk a little bit about what he means to the program and the person and player that he is?
Yeah, first of all, he's a great teammate. You know, he's one of our leaders, too. And just one of those positive guys, brings positive energy, and he loves this place. You know, he really, truly, you know, loves it. And I think that is important, too. He's got a lot of respect from his teammates and coaches, so we were extremely excited for him.
actually getting ready for a game this week, but a lot of people say it's going to get really crazy next week when there's recruiting and there's the transfer portal window. What are your expectations for how the month of December is going to unfold as far as that goes?
Yeah, I mean, we're in a new age of college football with this transition. It probably will be a little different than what we've all experienced. You just got to adapt. You got to be open-minded, and you know that's really what our approach is going to be. We're in a really good spot recruiting, like really good. We just need to make sure we finish, so that's kind of where we're at.
You'll be without Kobe Perry for the first half of the game on Saturday. Would you have liked to see more discipline? I know it's a rivalry game, things get chippy, but what did you make of that whole situation where both teams were unsportsmanlike conduct on both sides?
Well, first of all, you shouldn't hit the guy late. I mean, that's not very disciplined. You know, and then you hit a guy late on their sideline. So we got to be smarter in the future. I'm disappointed in that. And so we got to be smarter in that.
I think the stat is if you're a UCF player and you enter the program and maybe beginning in 04, and if you stayed the entire 4 years, you won a conference championship. And that would still be the case if UCF were to win one this year. That streak would still be intact. So how important is it to kind of leave your legacy in the American with another conference championship?
Yeah, I mean, this is a great program, you know, and they won so many championships, like you said. And the guys that come here, that's their expectations. And, you know, it's right in front of us. We're playing with the better teams in college football for the second time on their home field. It's a big challenge, but it's a challenge that we're looking forward to. And like I said, these guys come here expecting to win championships, and so, you know, it's a big game.
You mentioned John Rice has been battling something, dealing with some sort of health issue. How do you approach practice with him during this week?
Yeah, you know, you just kind of use your instincts from a coach's standpoint about, you know, practice and what it looks like and how much and all that. So we'll just kind of take it day by day with him. And, you know, he's a pretty honest young man, too, communicating how he's feeling. That's the way we'll go about it.
How rejuvenating or what was it like midway last week? Yeah, I'm sure everyone was still a little bit down in the dumps after what happened against Navy, but you see the ranking come out, and so you knew you win and you're in. Is that a real jolt of enthusiasm midweek to kind of get ready for this final stretch?
Yeah, and I felt pretty strong that if we won, we were going to be in. But you don't know officially until that comes out. So I would say, yeah, there was, you know, you know, we didn't say anything in the team room and all that, but our players knew. And, you know, our team meeting Sunday, we said if we win, we're going to play in a conference championship. But that confirmed it, you know, on Tuesday.
Coach, given your experience, you've obviously been a part of championship-level teams. What gives you the most confidence that this UCF team is championship-level?
Yeah, just because I like our leadership. I like our team. You know, we played really, really good football at times, and it's a one-game season right now, and it's right there before us. And this is what our goal and our dream has been. We're familiar with the team, and we've been there. So, you know, we're looking forward to playing them. All right. Thank you, guys.